Hello and welcome to Whitney High School Live. My name is Nafisa and I'll be your host for today. So we've been in quarantine for almost a year now and there's been some tension about how things are going to open up. So we wanted to give you guys a quick COVID update with Ezra.
Hey guys, my name is Ezra, and I'm going to be going over the brochure that ABCUSD released on reopening our schools. Since the entire PDF ranges 18 pages, I'm not going to go too far into details, so enjoy. Whenever you enter the school, you're going to be given a mandatory temperature check, and all students and faculty are supposed to wear masks wherever they are. There are also going to be designated routes for entry and exit into and out of the campus. So instead of taking this route to get out, some students will have to take this route to leave the school. On the bus, there are going to be assigned seats with only one student per bench. Now, I don't know how they're going to be doing that with two or three buses only, but we're going to need a lot more information on that in the future. Oh yeah, and by the way, buses are going to be disinfected every bus run. Of course, there is going to be a problem with super crowded halls. So like I said earlier, there are going to be pre-marked exit and entry routes for lunch. Class is going to look a little different in the way that everyone is wearing masks and that everyone will be spaced 6 feet apart and facing straight forward. Sports were organized into low risk, moderate risk, and high risk. You can read this table here if you want to know more. If there was a positive case in the school, then the school will personally notify those who had close contact with that person. To be completely clear, this applies to the whole district, it's just that primary is planning on opening before secondary. We also don't know when schools are reopening yet. And this was just a quick summary from me. You can check out the entire brochure in the link in the description. Thanks for watching, guys!
Now, this week is actually Foreign Language Week. So next up, we have some interviews from teachers about what Foreign Language Week means to them.
So I speak Spanish with my family. Whenever I go visit Mexico, I'm able to easily speak with others. And since I'm conversational in French and Italian, the couple times that I've gone with my family to Europe, I've been able to be like our tour guide and like go through the menu or at least be able to read street signs so that we're not completely lost tourists. So I just love that it opens more worlds to me and more connections to others.
One thing that I love about speaking another language is that I get to surprise people when they don't know I speak their language.
One thing I love about speaking another language is eavesdropping on people speaking that language in public because they don't think anyone can understand, but I do.
For me, it's been about getting a job. When I first started teaching, because I could speak and write and read Korean and I'm a teacher in another subject, I was able to actually get a full-time job at Cerritos High School. And I started a Korean program, so I taught Korean and biology at the same time. So I was able to get a job.
First, listening in on conversations I have no business listening into, and that's just because I'm super nosy, and also just being able to communicate with a variety of people, and so people being able to feel comfortable speaking to me, even if English isn't their preferred language, especially in everyday life outside of the classroom, and knowing what is appropriate or inappropriate to say in certain times, especially with authority.
Is I really like the respect and courtesy it affords the people whose language I'm speaking. Like, I like the fact that as a traveler, it's nice to see the reactions you get when you see people, you know, appreciating the fact that you're taking the time to speak to them in their own language and show them that courtesy and respect.
J'ai hérité d'un livre qui est bien plus qu'une histoire.
Thank you so much. That was very insightful. So coming up soon is something very exciting, talent show. So next up we have a video with a little more information.
To know you better, kinda hope we're here forever. There's nobody on these streets. If you told me that the world's ending, ain't no other way that I could spend it.
Hope you guys are excited for Talent Show, because I definitely am. Next up, we have a small holiday video by Athena.
Hey, Whitney. Unfortunately, for the last year, we haven't been able to see each other, but we don't want that to stop us from being able to virtually interact with each other. We are going to start doing monthly polls on different topics. We will reveal the winner of each poll at the end of every month, so get excited, Wildcats! To enter your vote, go to our Instagram, @WhitneyHS.live, and comment your answer under the post for the monthly poll. Don't forget to add in some extra comments for a little friendly competition. With St. Patrick's Day around the corner and Easter coming up, for the month of March, the poll question is, what is your favorite holiday? Check our Instagram now to tell us your answer and stay tuned at the end of the month to see which holiday reigns supreme.
And now we have a video from Masquerade Club.
Hey Whitney, I'm Maxime Garcia, the president of Masquerade Club, our drama club here on campus. And this year we've been doing a lot, even though we're virtual. We even have a play coming up that you can stream online. And right now we're going to be showcasing one of our amazing singers, Roshni Power, singing Waving Through a Window from Dear Evan Hansen. Take it away.
I've learned to slam on the brake before I even turn the key, before I make the mistake, before I lead with the worst of me. Give them no reason to stare, no slipping up if you slip away. So I've got nothing to share, no, I've got nothing to say. Step out of the sun if you keep getting burned. Step out of the sun because you've learned. On the outside, always looking in, will I ever be more than I've always been? 'Cause I'm tapping on the glass, waving through a window. I try to speak, but nobody can hear, so I wait around for an answer to appear while I'm watching people pass, waving through a window. Can anybody see? Is anybody waving back at me?
Alright, and now last, but definitely not least, we have another makeup video from Reese, this time with a voiceover from Key Club.
Hey Whitney, it's Maya, president of Whitney Key Club, and today we are going to be doing Reese's voiceover, but we did want to highlight some of Key Club's major accomplishments. We were able to fundraise over $3,000 and serve over 10,000 service hours, which is a record breaker for Whitney, so thank you to those of you who put in that work, who donated. It is all greatly appreciated and recognized. Now we're going to throw it over to other members of Cabinet to further explain some of the major accomplishments that we had as a club this year.
Hi everyone, it's Ayush, and I'm one of the current director of activities for Whitney Key Club. Besides service, Key Club also focuses on fundraising for different charities. We have 4 significant preferred charities, with one of them being the Pediatric Trauma Program, or PTP for short. This charity is beyond remarkable since it focuses on reducing the number of children who are killed or injured by trauma. Unintentional injury is the number one killer of children aged 14 and under in the US, and PTP helps combat this. Whitney Key Club has continuously been working hard to fundraise for PTP, despite the current circumstances, by holding food nights, game and movie night fundraisers, and so much more.
Hi everyone, this is Jerick, and I also serve as one of Key Club's Director of Activities. Another main preferred charity is our partnership with UNICEF, where one of their main campaigns is eliminating MMT, or maternal and neonatal tetanus. This epidemic is claiming lives of babies and their mothers still in 12 different countries, and a single donation of $1.80 will provide a vaccine saving their lives. In an effort to promote the Eliminate Project, we hosted an Eliminate Week back in January alongside UNICEF Club, where we hosted different activities while also raising over $102 in funds for this initiative thanks to you guys. So, the next time you see Whitney Key Club holding a fundraiser, don't be afraid to participate since you'll be helping such a tremendous cause.
Hey Whitney, it's Sadvi, Key Club's treasurer. If you have not joined our beautiful club yet, then do so right now because you do not want to miss out on one of our largest events, Lock-In. Lock-In is a 12-hour service event where members can do many service activities to help give back to the community. Some activities we've done in the past include making peanut butter jelly sandwiches for the homeless, dog and cat toys for animals at shelters, dolls for pediatric trauma patients, paracord bracelets for our veterans, and so much more. But more than the service, Lock-In is a great way for you to take a break from the stress of school and hang out with your friends. You meet so many new people and learn so many new skills that will stay with you forever. This year, due to the pandemic, Lock-In was online over Zoom. But despite the circumstances, we were able to raise over $400 from the event for the Pediatric Trauma Program and give back to our community's veterans, shelters, hospitals, and children. So Whitney, I hope to see you at Lock-In next year, shining with service and spirit.
Hey everyone, my name is Ayan and I am the Vice President of Key Club. This December, as you all may remember, Key Club hosted our annual Operation Christmas with the Salvation Army. We were able to support 4 families facing difficult times. The pandemic made fundraising in school extremely hard this year, yet this did not stop you amazingly generous students and faculty from helping the community. With the help of volunteers who held individual, socially distanced canned food drives, we were able to receive over 700 cans of food in addition to other non-perishable food items and household cleaning supplies. Furthermore, we raised $1,644 for the 4 families. Such was used to buy gifts for the families and household supplies as simple as pots and pans. The remainder of the money was given directly to the families so that they may go out and purchase any extra food or gifts they may need. Operation Christmas was a huge success due to the help of all of the students and faculty in Whitney High School, as well as the support from the Kiwanis Club of La Palma. Thank you so much to everyone who donated to Operation Christmas. Also, thank you so much to all the volunteers who helped with our canned food drive, as well as ASB and club leaders on campus who helped Key Club plan and organize the event this year. It was such a privilege serving Whitney Key Club these past years. I will miss this school and all you amazing students and faculty.
Hey everyone, it's Maya once again. Can I just say that I am so beyond incredibly proud of all of the members who have given Whitney Key Club the name of being the top in the entire division. Like, you are all just so amazing. You are all the reason why all of the things listed in this video were as successful as it was. But something that I did on my part was, this past summer I decided that since fundraisers per usual could not be held, I started my own little online sticker business called Maya's Makes. I was able to sell stickers and digital prints to a multitude of customers and give all of my proceeds to both the Pediatric Trauma Program and Operation Christmas. This opportunity of designing, creating, and shipping my stickers to paying customers was so eye-opening, and with this project I was able to give back to the club that has given so much to me. So thank you so much, Whitney Key Club, for supporting me in my endeavors and continuing to serve your community. If you are interested in purchasing stickers or have a digital print being done, be sure to follow Maya's Makes on Instagram, and this is where I will continue to sell all of my products and donate to these respective charities. I miss you all so much, and I cannot wait to see all of your beautiful faces once we return to school. But yeah, that is all. Bye guys.
Well, that's all we have for our show today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and have a great rest of your week.